myths about IVF treatment. There are lot of myths about IVF treatment in patients' mind. When we started before 20 years, people were believing that IVF treatment means it is somebody else's child. It took so much of counseling for us to make them understand that it is not so. It is their own eggs and their own sperm. We just do fertilization process outside their body, but whatever embryos we are replacing in the body of female partner is their own. And once the pregnancy is achieved, it is as good as natural pregnancy, and the delivery and the breastfeeding part also. So it is as good as their natural pregnancy, and nothing is different in IVF. Sometimes they feel that because of IVF process, they may get abnormal babies or babies with some anomalies. This is also not true, because we are using their own eggs and their own sperm and making just the fertilization process outside their body, and once the embryos are formed, we are replacing them back into the uterus. So it is just as good as normal pregnancy or natural pregnancy. And the percentage of anomalies are not higher as compared to natural pregnancy. So they should not feel that these babies are going to be more of an abnormal and less of a normal. We should clearly understand that this is not an artificial process, this is assisted process. The techniques which are used in IVF are known as ART, that is assisted reproductive technique. We just assist the fertilization process. There is nothing artificial involved in the process. Sometimes couple feel that once they undergo IVF process, they have to take a rest for 2 weeks, and once the result is if positive, they need to take rest throughout their pregnancy. But it is not so. Once the pregnancy is achieved, it is same, and once we do the embryo transfer and make them rest for 15 minutes after the transfer, they can do all their normal activities. They can go home by any mode of transportation. They can drive bike, car, etc. They can do air travel also. And there is not at all any restriction in their physical activities. They can do regular exercise, light exercise. They can climb stairs. They can go to the job. Or if they are not doing job, whatever they are doing as a regular routine activity, they can always do that. Same way, the food will not cause any problem after IVF treatment. Whatever food you are taking daily, you should take those food. Just avoid the junk food, that you may get ill because of the junk food. Otherwise, there is no restriction in the food. Same way, the season or weather doesn't change IVF outcome, because throughout the process of IVF, the gametes and the embryos are maintained at 37 degree temperature, which is our usual body temperature. And they just maintain throughout that only. So there is a common feeling that if we do the surgical process or surgeries during the cold environment, there may be a better outcome. But in IVF, it is not true, because our body 365 days works at 37 degree temperature. So as in IVF process also, all the things are maintained at 37 degree temperature. So the weather or season will not have any impact on the IVF outcome. Sometimes people feel that this is the last option I have. But there are few cases where this is the only and only first option for them. So it is not the case that this is the last option, but it is the best option for fertility treatment. So you should stay positive during your treatment, and that will enhance your success rates.